Good afternoon, everyone. I am the proud principal of Dwight D. Eisenhower K-8, and I am the only person standing between you and lunch. Dina? A setup, definitely. I am also your proud neighbor. My school is located just across the street, and we have continued to be blessed by all of you over the years, and our school, I can tell you, is much better because of all of you. So from the bottom of my heart and on behalf of my entire school family, a big thank you for all that you have done and continue to do. Usually I come here and tell you a little bit about our school, our choice program, our young environmental scientist program, and I think you've become part of our school family, and you have gotten to know our school over the years. So I'm just going to give you a few updates about our school. We have talked to you about our future, which was the room upstairs that we called the future. The future is now the present. And we have moved into our new wing, and we now serve students from pre-K. We have 152 pre-K students with disabilities, all the way up to grade 7. And next year, we will have our first group of 8th graders. So we will be a full pre-K 8 school. So we're very, very proud of that. And another big update, we continue to be a Title I school, which means that we serve families that do benefit from federal assistance. We are currently at the percent of 94%. We are a neighborhood school, so we do pull from our neighboring community, which is from PGA north to Donald Ross, and then from the west, alternate A1A to the waterway. But we do pull 40% of our students from outside of our area because of our choice program. So we do have a lot of students from Lake Park, West Palm Beach, and Riviera Beach, as well as some to the north of us. So continuing with our program, the wing upstairs, we opened it about 2 weeks ago, and that was super exciting. But now I just want to talk a little bit about our mission and how you have been able to make that a reality. We've continued through generous donations of your time, your sweat, your tears, your muscles, and your pure generosity. And you can see the list of items up on the presentation board. Most recently, our garden was completely overgrown, and it takes quite some time to be able to prep a garden for young children to be able to go out and plant. So this was something that just happened a few weeks ago. Our garden is completely prepped and looks amazing. And we started the first day back with teachers where we gave everyone an herb and we started our own herb garden. So we figured, how do you divide 10 tomatoes among 130 staff members? But herbs is something that everyone can take a little snip and bring out and add to their delicious dinner. So that was such a nice way of coming together as a school community after being apart all summer and being able to partake in that. So thank you so much for making that happen. Greatly appreciated. And now our kids are starting their seedlings in their classrooms, and we'll be able to go outside to a nice, beautifully prepped garden. We've continued with one of the things with years ago when you provided us with back-to-school supplies and backpacks was we would go out massively and distribute. And we found that a better way of doing that was creating a school store. And we tell the children that they can come shopping in the school store, but the way that they have to pay for things is with a smile. So they have to get their smile on as they walk in, and that's their currency that they use, and they get to shop for free and fill their backpacks if needed, or if the teacher knows that there are certain things that they need, we pull it from the shelves. So we've been able to create a Google Doc that keeps track of all the items in there, and teachers can either place orders electronically and we deliver them every Friday, or kids can come and go shopping, and it's so delightful to see their faces when they're able to fill their backpacks with much needed supplies. So thank you for making that happen. Dina just gave me another box that I put in the car, so I can't wait to add that to our inventory on Monday. sponsoring field trips over the years for children who can't afford it. You've paid off school lunches for kids that had debt. You've provided sanitizers. You've provided batteries. You've provided extension cords so we can charge our devices. I think that's the only good thing that came out of COVID is every child now has a device, so that's pretty cool. And charging them is important. You've provided us treats and things for our staff to recognize them. They work so incredibly hard. People think, oh, a teacher, June, July, August, that's pretty amazing. You get off. They work. They beg me to come in. They're decorating their rooms. They're doing lesson plans. And they give their heart and soul to their kids. So little trinkets along the way, we thank you for that. Additional ways that we look out to our community to continue to support is keeping that school store going, continuing with field trips for kids that need the assistance. Staff appreciation can be as tiny as a $10 gift card. We decided to do Monday Fun Day once a month for staff because Mondays aren't the best. Like, we always do the fun things on Fridays. So we thought we need to get them excited about Mondays. So our first Monday Fun Day was a bead for each person and a rock, paper, scissors competition. They were competitive. They walked around and spoke to staff that maybe they've never spoken to. Our school's very divided logistically with having pre-K, elementary, and middle school. And I realize not everyone knows everyone, 130 staff members. So one of the rules to challenge someone was they had to make an introduction and a connection of some sort. So at the end, we gave away a couple gift cards for coffee, Dunkin' Donuts, Starbucks, and you would have thought that was gold. So little things like that are great ways for staff appreciation and to get people excited. And if the teachers are happy and well-fed, they won't eat the children. So that's very, very important. A new initiative that we are working on is called the Ron Clark Academy. You may have seen the story of Ron Clark, a movie that was made years ago. We were fortunate to be able to send 8 staff members to Atlanta and visit the school. And I came back and I think my hair was on fire. I was so motivated and couldn't wait to come back and share with my staff. And now we're rolling it out to the children. So that is one initiative that's really high energy. And to hear the other speakers talk, the children need a sense of belonging. They need to feel that they're cared about and that they are loved. And this house system is a remarkable way of doing that. And it's like having little fraternities or sororities at an elementary, middle school level where no one sits alone in the cafeteria. No one stands alone at recess. And if you see someone from your house that needs to be pulled in and hugged and encouraged, that's a big part of our school family. So we're bringing that in and trying to have ways of spreading the word. So if anyone had interest of how they can help support us with that, that big wheel, one of my staff members created it. That's how we sort which house you're part of. And yes, it's a spatula at the bottom that makes the spinner go tick, 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 and it made the best noise, and that's how they get sorted into their house. So if you need to feel a sense of belonging, we'd rather it be through something like this versus finding your own way through a gang or in relationships that are not healthy. So thank you for listening, and thank you for continuing to support us over the years. You've really made an incredible difference, and I hope all of you know the impact that you've made for me personally, as well as for my school family. And I think it's almost lunchtime, right?